Roland Garros, aviator. Eugène Adrien Roland Georges Garros, October 6, 1888, October 5, 1918, was a French pioneering aviator and fighter pilot during World War I and early days of aviation. Eugène Adrien Roland Georges Garros was born in Saint-Denis, Réunion, and studied at the Lycée Janson de Sailly in Hec, Paris. He started his aviation career in 1909 flying a Demoiselle, Dragonfly, monoplane, an aircraft that only flew well with a small lightweight pilot. He gained A.C.F. license number 147 in July 1910. In 1911, Garros graduated to flying Blériot monoplanes and entered a number of European air races with this type of machine, including the 1911 Paris to Madrid air race and the Circuit of Europe, Paris-London-Paris, in which he came second. On September 4, 1911, he set an altitude record of. The following year, on September 6, 1912, after Austrian aviator Philipp von Blaschke had flown to, he regained the height record by flying to. By 1913 he had switched to flying the faster Moissonnier monoplanes, and gained fame for making the first non-stop flight across the Mediterranean Sea from Fréjus in the south of France to Bizerte in Tunisia in a Moissonnier G. The following year, Garros joined the French army at the outbreak of World War I. Reports published in August 1914 claimed Garros was involved in the first air battle in world history and that he had flown his plane into a Zeppelin, destroying the airship and killing its pilots and himself. This story was quickly contradicted by reports that Garros was alive and well in Paris. Such early reports maintained that an unidentified French pilot had indeed rammed and destroyed a Zeppelin. However, German authorities denied the story. Later sources indicated the first aerial victory against a Zeppelin occurred in June 1915 and that earlier reports, including that of Garros, had been discredited. In the early stages of the air war in World War I, the problem of mounting a forward-firing machine gun on combat aircraft was considered by a number of individuals. The so-called interrupter gear did not come into use until Anthony Fokker developed a synchronization device which had a large impact on air combat. However, Garros also had a significant role in the process of achieving this goal. As a reconnaissance pilot with the Escadrille MS-26, Garros visited the Moissonnier works in December 1914. Sonnier's work on metal deflector wedges attached to propeller blades was taken forward by Garros. He eventually had a workable installation fitted to his Moissonnier Type L aircraft. The Aero Club of America awarded him a medal for this invention 3 years later. Garros achieved the first ever shooting down of an aircraft by a fighter firing through a tractor propeller. On April 1, 1915, two more victories over German aircraft were achieved on 15 and April 18, 1915. On April 18, 1915, either Garros's fuel line clogged or, by other accounts, his aircraft was downed by ground fire, and he glided to a landing on the German side of the lines. Garros failed to destroy his aircraft completely before being taken prisoner. Most significantly, the gun and armored propeller remained intact. Legend has it that after examining the plane, German aircraft engineers, led by Fokker, designed the improved interrupter gear system. In fact, the work on Fokker's system had been going for at least 6 months before Garros's aircraft fell into their hands. With the advent of the interrupter gear, the tables were turned on the Allies, with Fokker's plane shooting down many Allied aircraft, leading to what became known as the Fokker Scourge. Garros finally managed to escape from a POW camp in Germany on February 14, 1918, after several attempts, and rejoined the French army. He settled into Escadrille 26 to pilot a SPAD, and claimed two victories on October 2, 1918, one of which was confirmed. On October 5, 1918, he was shot down and killed near Vouzers, Ardennes, a month before the end of the war and 1 day before his 30th birthday. His adversary was probably German ace Hermann Habeck from Jasta 49. Garros is erroneously called the world's first fighter ace. In fact, he shot down only 4 aircraft. The definition of ace is 5 or more victories. The honor of becoming the first ace went to another French airman, Adolphe Pegaud, who had 6 victories early in the war. A tennis center constructed in Paris in the 1920s was named after him, the Stade Roland Garros. The stadium accommodates the French Open, one of the 4 Grand Slam tennis tournaments. Consequently, the tournament is officially called Les Internationaux de France de Roland Garros, the French Internationals of Roland Garros. According to Vu Trong Fung's urban novel, Dum Luc, 1936, during colonial times the Hanoi government named the city's main tennis stadium after Roland Garros. airports. The International Airport of La Réunion, Roland Garros Airport, is also named after him. There is a monument to Garros in Bizerte at the site of his landing, which is called Roland Garros Plaza. The French car manufacturer Peugeot commissioned a Roland Garros limited edition version of its 205 model in celebration of the tennis tournament that bears his name. The model included special paint and leather interior. Because of the success of this special edition, Peugeot later created Roland Garros editions of its 106, 108, 206, 207, 208, 306, 307, 406, and 806 models. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.